The Criminal Code from 1931 was directed by legendary director Howard Hawks, who slowly I've been watching more and more films by, such as Thing from Another World, His Girl Friday, and so on. I really like the eclectic subjects he picks, and yes, as I dig into old movies from the past, I'm going to continue to watch a lot of his movies. Well, The Criminal Code is a prison movie, and I recently watched the film Convicted with Glenn Ford from 1950, which was straight up a remake of this film from 1931, and it was really a faithful remake. Most of the elements, the characters, and the scenes are exactly the same, and that was pretty cool. Well, this film opens up just the same way. Two detectives are called off to a nightclub where a guy has been injured in a fight. The doctor is treating the injured man, and the detectives go to talk with Robert Graham, actor Phillips Holmes, who caused the injury. And he seems like a decent guy, and he explains that he didn't mean to hurt the other guy in the fight so severely. So Robert and the girl that he was with, Gertrude, played by actress Mary Duran, they're brought to speak with the DA, this character Mark Brady, who's played by legendary actor Walter Houston, who is this tough, no-nonsense kind of guy. You know, I caught him recently in Treasure of Sierra Madre with Bogart. And he's definitely a lot younger in the role here. A lot less grizzled, a little less of the Gabby Hayes. And he speaks with Robert and tells him that the guy that he beat up has died. And Robert seems really distraught about it. So, you know, the kid leaves and the DA speaks with the character Leonard Nettleford, played by Arthur Hoyt, who is this mousy attorney representing Robert. And of course, as you'd expect, he doesn't fare well in the court. Robert is found guilty and sent off to prison. Time passes and he's in his cell, looking weary and depressed, and he's lamenting his situation with his cellmates, one of whom, the character Galloway, is played by legendary actor Boris Karloff. And yes, I keep saying legendary in the review, I will stop. And yeah, it's Boris Karloff looking, you know, big and intimidating like usual. Otto Hoffman plays Jim Fales, another cellmate with him. Well, Robert gets news in his cell that his mom has died, and he just freaks out about it, as you would expect. And Galloway ends up giving him a punch to the face to knock him out so that they can explain it away to the warden to keep him from getting into trouble. Well, the DA, this Mark Brady character, he takes the role of the warden in the prison. He arrives there with his daughter Mary, played by Constance Cummings, and Miss Ryan, his housekeeper, who to me sort of resembled one of the Emperor's advisors from Return of the Jedi. Sorry, just geeking out a little, but that was first impression. Well, they meet with the yard captain, Gleason, played by DeWitt Jennings, and soon the word gets out that there's a new warden there, and many of the prisoners remember him from before. So out in the yard, they do their yammering, and they start complaining about him and chanting, and just like in the film Convicted, the new warden decides just to go out and take a walk by himself through the prison yard, through the midst of all of the inmates. And they all slowly quiet down and disperse as he walks out through all of them. Well, we cut to Robert. He's working on machines, and he's looking weary and beaten, and he's really starting to crack up. So they decide, hey, we got to take him to the doctor. And after an exam, the doctor says, you know, talk to the warden. You're going to get a role change. So the warden, Brady, meets with Robert, gives him a chance to be his personal chauffeur and drive his lovely daughter around. Now, in real life, I don't know how realistic this particular situation is, but we'll go along with it. Well, he helps cut up some potatoes for her, and there seems to be a nice attraction between the two of them. Although, I noticed it was an interesting thing about this film, it featured very little music. The romantic scenes between the two of them might have been helped with a little bit of orchestration, a little bit of strings, but, you know, we'll let it go. Back in his cell, Jim says he is going to plan a breakout, but Robert is no longer interested. And sure enough, Jim is trying to escape later and is shot and killed because of a squealer. Well, later the warden gets the straight razor shave from the character Red Fleshman, who is an inmate he has personally sent away for cutting a guy's throat. And of course, after mentioning this, he finishes his shave of the neck with a straight razor. And it's crazy and creepy stuff, to be honest. You know, as a guy with a beard, I take stuff like that, you know, very seriously. Well, we find out that the betrayer from earlier, this character Runch, who's played by this mousy Clark Marshall actor, is kept around in the office as a clerk. But clearly he's a liability. And the inmates in the yard, they plan this loud mass protest to give the character Galloway a chance to sneak in and kill him. Sure enough, Galloway manages to give some sleeping meds to the housekeeper, sneaks in, and before you know it, there's Boris Karloff creeping in for a kill. Oh man, watch out, Runch! Well, Galloway commits the murder, sneaks away, and seeing Robert, tells him, hey, get out of here, leave. But Robert was ordered by the warden to stay behind, so he does. The warden and Captain Gleason arrive, they find the body, they see Robert, and they try to get a confession out of him, but you know that criminal code. He refuses to talk. So basically, he's in this difficult position of going along with the warden's pleading, you know, with the potential romance of the warden's daughter, too, and the criminal code of silence. Well, Robert is in quite a pickle. Well, what will he decide? And will the schemes of that Galloway character lead to more trouble? Well, you need to watch the film to find out for yourself. So some quick closing thoughts. You know, I enjoyed this one. As I mentioned before, it's pretty much identical to the film Convicted from 1951. And although I'm not a fan of prison films necessarily as a genre, I do like how they depict the enclosed, claustrophobic feel of life in a prison cell and a lot of the elements that make it feel like you're really there. As mentioned, it was directed by Howard Hawks, and he's got this diverse collection of films. It's just so neat. And apparently, this one was enough of a commercial success from the studio that they had Hawks follow up with directing the film Scarface, which is one I really need to check out. And from what I've read, Hawks, when he made this movie, did something unusual, and he actually hired dozens of ex-convicts to help him out, not only with the making of the end of the film to make it more authentic, but they also incorporated some of these ex-convicts as actually actors in the film. So that's pretty cool. Walter Houston does a great job as this no-nonsense yet sympathetic warden in the prison. Now, both he and Broderick Crawford from the film Convicted really managed to make the warden a decent, sympathetic character that you really believe in. Constance Cummings does a fine job as his daughter, who plays an important role later in the film of pleading for the life of Robert. And I believe from what I've read, this was her first film role. And of course, Boris Karloff is, as usual, amazing in this film. There was a quote from director Howard Hawks about Karloff. It's that, in the criminal code, I gave Boris stance. I wanted that huge, menacing figure, and Boris wasn't really tall, as you know, so because I wanted him to appear so huge, I ended up shooting a part of the scene through his legs. Yeah, and no doubt this role here was a springboard for his future roles, namely as the Frankenstein monster. And it's interesting that Karloff had actually previously played the role of Galloway in the stage production of this as well. So this was a good film. Really enjoyed this one. The acting, the elements of the prison, claustrophobic feel. It was really good stuff, very well done. I would recommend both this, The Criminal Code from 1931, and also the film Convicted from the 1950s with Glenn Ford. They're both great, gritty prison movies with believable characters, and they're both worth checking out.